guys, today we will discuss about COSY. Okay, first we will see this in COSY. First of all, it must have j coupled to each other. Okay, they should have coupling in it. Okay, now the next is the preparation stage p1, this p1, and a mixing period p2. In between this p1 and p2, there we have a mixing period. Okay, there we have mixing period P2, each consists of a single 90 degree radio frequency. In each, there we have a 90 degree radio frequency at time T1. Okay, but after that, the sample signal is detected, which is described by T2, which is detected by time T2. Okay, now we will discuss about what is COSY and how we will see that. COSY is used to define the coupling. Okay. The real thing is the COSY is used to define the coupling. Now we will see how we will know the coupling. COSY is used to identify spins. Okay, first of all, we will see that it will identify the spins that are coupled to one another. Only that spins are identified which are coupled to one another. Okay, now COSY spectra consist of two types of peaks. Now there we have diagonal peak and cross peak. Now we will study about diagonal peak and cross peak. It's not a big game to represent this. Diagonal peak and cross peak, what we have? Diagonal peaks which have the same frequency. Okay, it has the same frequency at 1, 2, all 2 coordinate to the all axis. Okay, diagonal peaks which have same frequency coordinate on both axes, cross peak have different values for each frequency coordinates and a pair of diagonals. Okay, now we will see what about off diagonals. I will show a diagram after this, and you can call it that. What is the meaning of that off diagonal? Okay, cross peak results for the phenomena called magnetization transfer. It's will result from the phenomena called magnetization transfer. This cross peak, their presence indicates that the two nuclei that coupled have different value of chemical shift. If there we have cross peak, then there will be a different value of chemical shift. Each coupling gives rise to two symmetrical cross peak above and below the diagram. Now I will show the diagram, and then we can find that what is the meaning of this of one above and one below. Okay, now let's see. Now there we have a diagram. If we will see this, there we have this. This is a cross peak. If you can see above and below. Okay. Now we will have to know this. This is okay. Now see there. COSY 90. Okay, there we have COSY 90. Now I will show you what is COSY 90. Is the most common COSY experiment. In this 90 degree P1 pulse tilt the nuclear spin by 90, like this. This to this. This to this 90. Okay. Again, we will see COSY 90 is the most common COSY experiment. In this 90 P1 pulse tilt the nuclear spin by 90 degree. Another COSY is COSY 45. It's also an thing that's there. We have COSY 45. The advantage of COSY 45 is that the diagonal peak are less predominant, making it similar to match cross peaks near the diagonal in the large molecule. Okay. Now there we see there we have a preparation time. There we have RF pulse. Okay, this is the time of evolution. We will take time of evolution, and then there will be again RF pulse, and we will get a detection. This time we will get a detection. I will say you earlier that the preparation time and the evolution time we got from T1, and after that when we file the detection, it will occur from T2. Okay, now next we have what is the meaning of relaxation delay. Okay, when we will prepare, then there will be a time from to give evolution. I can say that evolution time T1, then before this we will have two stages of time to get the RF pulse. So at the preparation of mix 1, or we can say that the evolution of time T1 or evolution of time T2 is actually called the relaxation delay. Okay, now the next one is this we can say that now further we will know. There we have a diagonal peak. This is the diagonal peak, which is same. This diagonal peak, which is same, but this cross peak is different. Okay, at where the diagonal peak and the cross peak intersect, there we have a peak. Okay, it will show that these are coupled. Okay, let's take an example. There we have a chlorine CH2. Now we will see that CH2 interact with CH2. Okay, means first CH2 is interact with CH2 and second CH2 interact with CH3, but first CH2 does not directly interact with CH3 or does not couple with CH3, directly coupled with, but these two couple with each other. Okay, so now there we have a diagonal peak at one and diagonal peak at two at second carbon and diagonal peak at three at third carbon. Okay, and there we have a cross peak. This cross peak shows that the diagonal peak CH2 and the diagonal peak CH3, they are coupled to each other, but one doesn't couple to third. Now that's the real concept to show that the spin coupling. Okay, this is known as COSY. Okay, the real thing is we will have to identify the spin and couples to each other.